Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, warm welcome all of you to Thailand Focus 2020. This year is the 13th of Thailand Focus, the flagship event of the Thai capital market and the longest portfolio investment conference in Thailand. The theme for this year is Resiliency to Move Forward, which emphasizes issues through global pandemic of COVID-19, how country deals with the situations, and what will be the next steps. Thailand Focus 2020 is arranged by the Stock Exchange of Thailand with Kai collaboration from ASCO, Association of Securities Companies, and Bloomberg as a media partner. The session will start from a welcome address by Dr. Phakon Pithattawattai, President of the Stock Exchange of Thailand, followed by the opening speech by Minister of Finance, Mr. Pridee Dawchai. So we are now invite Dr. Phakon Pithattawattai, President of the Stock Exchange of Thailand, to deliver his welcome address. Please welcome.
Minister of Finance, Mr. Pridee Dawchai, Chairman of the Stock Exchange of Thailand, Dr. Chaiwat Vibhun Sawat, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It's my great pleasure to welcome you all to Thailand Focus 2020. This year's conference is the first virtual Thailand Focus that uses innovative digital technology to communicate to investors all over the world. On behalf of the Stock Exchange of Thailand, I would like to express my sincere appreciation to our keynote speakers, panelists, and partners for being instrumental in this annual flagship event. Ladies and gentlemen, the impact of COVID-19 pandemic has resulted in not only health crisis, but also the disruption in the global economy. The outbreak shocked the world in all levels, from countries, societies, and households. As a result, I would like to take this opportunity to show how resilient the Thai capital market is and how the Thai company have transformed into the new normal world. During the first quarter of this year, the pandemic and global economic worries hit the Thai capital market and hit the worldwide capital market, resulting in set index to drop drastically in March and April. However, with the aid of the three main resilience in the Thai capital market, we have navigated through difficult period quite well. Let me give you a brief on the resiliency of the Thai capital market. The resiliency number one, the speed of recovery. From the first confirmed case of the COVID-19 infected in Thailand on January 31st, the set index dropped by 37% and rebound to almost the pre-crisis level in early June. The index has quickly bounced back within just a few months. As Thailand has cautiously started to open businesses and guardedly opened the selected trip from overseas, the market and industry indices have gradually recovered. Strong recovery are in consumer product and agro and food industry that are now even at the higher level than the pre-COVID. Certain sectors such as digital technology, logistics, and healthcare will have high potential in the new normal world. Resilience number two, the opportunities. There are still plenty of opportunity in the market. New IPO that have been postponed during the COVID period has now getting active again. For this year, despite the interruption caused by pandemic, almost $3 billion have already been raised, which is comparable to the level of the previous years, with more than 30 securities are still waiting in the pipeline. Resilience number three, sentiment to invest in equity market. With the government-supported economic measure in place and the outbreak is under control in Thailand, local Thai investors have obviously become very active. Retail investor participation has surged and propelled the average daily trading volume to more than $2 billion per day in 2020. Noticeably, About 190,000 new retail trading accounts were opened during the first half of this year, 34% more than the entire last year. Ladies and gentlemen, with the pandemic disrupting businesses all over the world, companies are now looking to rethink of their strategies, rebuild their revenue, and secure the continuity. I would like to point out the transformation of the Thai companies into this new normal world into two aspects. First, adaptation, and secondly, sustainability. First, on adaptation. For companies to survive future challenges, they need to be able to adapt quickly to the environmental change. From our survey, we find that Thai companies are highly adaptive in four areas. First, on their product and services. Their product and services are now redesigned to suit the new normal era better. E-commerce, data analytics, sanitary standard improvement are employed so that the service and product can be directed to the target customer without any health concern. Secondly, the process improvement to ensure continuity, connectivity, and accessibility to service from employees to customers. Thirdly, cash flow liquidity and diversified supply chain has to be well managed, and that already happened. Particularly, these issues are so important for SME and smaller company. And fourth and lastly, people management, which is a very important factor for the company to move ahead. Since it is evident that employees are the most valuable resource of the company in the new normal world, supportive measures for safe and happy employment, like working anywhere, platform, online meeting, are a must. Let me now move on to the second transformation of the new normal Thai company, that is on the issue of sustainability. Thai-listed companies have been progressively in embracing the ESG and sustainability in their operation. They have been punching above their weight in Global Sustainable Investing Index. For the sixth consecutive year in a row, Thailand has the highest number of listed companies in the Dow Jones Sustainability Indices in the Asian region. In addition, Thai-listed companies have the highest score in 7 sectors of the DJSI. Their contribution makes SEB being recognized as one of the most sustainable exchanges in the world. To further promote our listed company in embracing ESG and sustainability as the key strategic direction, SEB has launched Thailand Sustainability Investment Index as one of our unique value proposition to recognize firm that pass the sustainability standard. The list has grown from 51 companies in 2016 to 98 companies in 2019, with market value of $365 billion and accounting for 65% of the total market capitalization. Moving ahead, we will encourage all sizes of company to focus on ESG and sustainability, since we truly believe that this quality will become the standard to look for when any company wants to raise the fund. We firmly believe that companies with the ESG in practice are more resilient to changes, and we are looking forward to see more fund investing in sustainable companies. Ladies and gentlemen, now challenges will occur in the world without any warnings. We have to strike the balance between the risk concern and the growth of the economy to adapt to the new normal and prepare for the next disruption. I believe that Thai-listed companies are ready to re-establish themselves and become stronger from the reason that I had mentioned. I wish that the global community well and trust that you will recognize the investment opportunity in Thailand amid this time of challenges and futures predictable or unpredictable surprises. Ladies and gentlemen, the next session will be the keynote address by His Excellency, the Minister of Finance, Mr. Pridi Dao Chai. Please welcome His Excellency.
Executives from public and private sectors, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to speak before the distinguished institutional investors and financial professionals. First, I would like to extend my appreciation towards the Stock Exchange of Thailand for successfully hosting the first virtual Thailand Focus event amid the most unfavorable circumstances of our times. As my first public appearance as the Finance Minister, I would like to take this opportunity to reassure our distinguished viewers that the Thai government will carry out necessary economic and healthcare policy to sustain the level of economic growth and activities. I believe that in dealing with the COVID-19 crisis, policymakers must be forward-looking and view the situation with utmost attention. Handling COVID-19 is tricky because no one can confirm when the vaccine will be approved. Until then, the global economy will likely remain below pre-COVID-19 level. Therefore, we have to brace and prepare ourselves for any unforeseeable risk. In that light, the Prime Minister has listed guidelines to be followed in order to safeguard the economy. First, we must extend remedy and support to the vulnerable groups and SME. Second, the country must be prepared when the global economy fully recovers in order to catch the waivers. Third, we need to promote job creation in the private sector. Fourth, there needs to be a concrete employment strategy to absorb the newly graduates. And lastly, the public sector needs to be transparent and encourages public participation in public service. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, this year has witnessed the worst global economic downturn in decades, a black swan that no one had anticipated. COVID-19 has shaken the global economy to the core. Thailand is no exception. Given our last exposure to foreign tourists, once the outbreak happened, we therefore took a swift action to contain the spread of the virus. The government has implemented a host containment measure, including lockdown in high-risk areas, travel restrictions, and setting up the Center for COVID-19 Situation Administration to tackle the disease effectively. Medical workers also perform rapid contact tracing and testing. Moreover, the Thai people have been greatly cooperative in practicing social distancing and wearing masks in public areas. These factors contribute greatly to our COVID-19 success. Thailand is at the forefront in terms of COVID-19 response. Thailand has ranked number one in the world out of 184 countries for its ongoing COVID-19 recovery efforts. According to the Global COVID-19 Index, putting us on top of the global chart as an example of best practices in tracking the ongoing global pandemic. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, despite the unfavorable climate, Thailand's economic fundamentals remain solid on both internal and external fronts, making Thailand one of the most resilient economies in the region. Thanks to the strength in our economic fundamentals, in the second quarter of this year, the Thai economy has performed relatively well. We believe that the worst is behind us. The economy is projected to bottom out in the second half of this year and would pick up in 2021 with 4-5% year-on-year. So far, in response to the COVID-19 induced recession, we have launched three phases of relief and stimulus packages worth approximately 2.2 trillion baht, or 12% of GDP, to help vulnerable households and businesses affected by pandemic. The package includes 1 trillion baht loan to fund the cash transfer programs and to spend for economic rehabilitation programs aiming at job creation projects and infrastructure investment in community level. The package also includes another 900 billion baht by the Bank of Thailand to ensure that there is enough liquidity in financial markets. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to share with you our strategy to address economic challenges from COVID-19. I hope that today's discussion will help you to better understand our future plan and gain your confidence in our economy as one of investment destinations to consider. Firstly, having strong policy coordination and speedy response is the key to successful policy implementation and economic recovery. To address the issue to weak coordination and response, our Prime Minister has set up the Economic Situation Administration Center, consisting of stakeholders in both private and public sectors. The center's focus is to promote Thailand's economic rehabilitation from the pandemic crisis. It will take charge of proposing solutions to tackle economic problems and supervise the government's economic rehabilitation efforts. The government will be able to respond to situations more swiftly and efficiently. The center will also ensure a better policy coordination among government agencies and the private sectors. Moreover, the Ministry of Finance sees big data and technology as swift means of helping the vulnerable group and individuals and SME. Technology has allowed us to better target the needy groups. As COVID-19 has led the suspension of many businesses, particularly in tourism and manufacturing, many have lost their jobs. Despite Thailand's effective social security safety net, there remain large groups of people excluded from the system. The informal workers, the self-employed, and small businesses were on the brink of losing their livelihood. We have leveraged our national e-payment network and big data, such as PromptPay and AI screening, to disburse cash handout accurately and timely. Our safety net policy has become more targeted and effective. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, in long term, we believe that building our national competitiveness will be the core of our economic accomplishment. In order to increase our national competitiveness, the Ministry of Finance is putting emphasis on increasing investment spending on large-scale investment via government agency and state-owned enterprise. Moreover, we have also encouraged public-private partnership as a way to attack investment without putting a fiscal strain on our budget. Some highlight investment projects include the Eastern Economic Corridor and the Transport Infrastructure Master Plan. These projects will be vital to Thailand's future industry. In addition to the infrastructure projects, the government has allocated 400 billion baht towards economic and social rehabilitation plan. The plan will focus on strengthening the local economy through job creating, building community tourism, and expediting village funds, investing in the new potential economic corridor in preparation for future growth and industry, new agriculture and quality tourism, and rekindle domestic consumption and tourism so that economy can get back on its feet again. Public and private investment will not only increase our national competitiveness, but also contribute to our economic stimulus and speedy recovery. Unarguably, investment are imperative to the country's development and resilience. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, the key to sustained growth and economic recovery is to maintain the fiscal discipline. Due to COVID-19, our budget for discretionary spending is limited. It is of importance to utilize our budget wisely and efficiently. The Thai government has continued to act in accordance with the fiscal sustainability law. Despite record government stimulus packages, Thailand's fiscal policy remains healthy. The Ministry of Finance has special attention on balancing our revenue and spending. At present, Thailand's public debt to GDP continues to be below 60%, even after accounting for the latest emergency loans of 1 trillion baht. albeit our budget limitation, we have not crossed our government borrowing as a policy options. We may have to resort to borrowing if necessary. However, it is of importance to pursue economic measures without sacrificing our physical integrity. To do what, we must ensure that all measures are directed toward the right projects and targeting the right people. Significantly, we must ensure the right programs are rolled out, and we must ensure that our limited pool of money is used properly and reaches the right people and with the right integrated mechanism. To achieve this, we need to operate with transparency and integrity, and to stay open to the opinion of all stakeholders. Everybody in our society has a role to play in helping us get through this challenge. The impact of the COVID-19 crisis on the society, economy, and vulnerable groups is fundamental to inform and tailor the responses of governments and partners to recover from the crisis and ensure that no one is left behind in the effort. We will get through together. The global surveys from various sources have recognized Thailand as one of the top countries that recover well during the post-COVID-19 crisis. We cannot help but thank our people with good guard up discipline and humbly hope that this fight and management against COVID-19 can be a model for other countries. We also thank our global communities for their cooperation. Notably, we hope that during the post-COVID period and afterwards, you will use Thailand as the hub for growth and have confidence in our policy and strategy that will enable Thailand to grow in a sustainable manner with inclusive opportunity and ready for global changes. Most of all, I hope that Thailand Focus 2020 will give all of you new insights and strengthen your confidence on the Thai economy and the economic strength. Thank you.